Hello my dear friends, hope you have understood the basics of pointers in previous video lecture. So in this video lecture I am going to teach you about the pointer arithmetic and the arrays. I'll try my best so that you can understand easily the topics of arrays and the pointers. So let's start from the basic again. So in this program, in my screen, in this program you can see I have declared a variable I is equal to 1. So go to the memory architecture, go to the memory actors here, the memory architecture, just this is a logical memory architecture, nothing about the physical one, means nothing about the actual memory architecture. For the sake of simplicity and make you understand, I have not considered the actual memory architecture. The diagram shown in ORD, you are watching that in old file, the diagram is totally logical, not the physical memory architecture. And as my machine in which operating system Windows 10 is running, it takes the 4 bytes for the integer data type, and I am going to use the integer data type to make you understand the pointers. So I have taken the memory blocks, means I have taken the memory blocks only 4 byte block only, okay, not the other 2 byte, 3 byte, or like any other data type. I have considered that the memory block is 4 byte, and so that just I, for the sake of simplicity, okay. And if you want, you can say me, then I can make a video in computer architecture, in the memory architecture for you if you want, okay. And just to make you understand the pointer, I have just drawn the figure or make the table as the logical, okay. So as in the program, I have declared a variable that is called I, and then initialized with the value 1. So let's see again how it works. So the value, a memory block will be stored, means a memory block will be reserved, and a value will be stored. The value is here 1, okay, and the name given is I, okay, simple. And after going there, then in next line, what I have done, I just simply increment it. Is then everybody knows that I is equal to I plus 1, means I plus plus, right? So I just incremented it, and see the what will be the output. Output is the value of i is 1 in this line, the initial value, and after incrementing it is 2, okay. And okay, let's make it I is equal to I plus 2, okay, it's 3, okay, just incremented by 2, means 2 is added. So now you can think that why I am going show some basic things, nah? So let's go to pointer now. So it means I am just make it clear that I have going to make it clear that what is the difference between some the general arithmetic and the pointer arithmetic, okay. So you have seen that if the value is 1 and I increment it, the value will be 2, and if the value is 1 and if I increment it by 2, that it will be in the 3. Simple. So let's go for the pointer things. Okay, so run it. So here what I have done, so int I is equal to 1, a variable is initialized and declared, and I have taken a pointer, and the star point ptr, the name is ptr only, yeah, ptr is equal to who, ptr will hold the address of I. So here in the diagram you can see the address of I is 6356728, right? And the value will be stored in the pointer. So go to the program, the value that I'm copying here, the value is copied from the memory to the, just to make you understand. So okay, so another pointer value will be the address of I. What is the address of I? So again which say that what is that, this is the variable I and the address of I is 6356728, and then the pointer, now the below pointer is 6356728. So definitely the address value which is stored in pointer is going to print this address only, right? The address which is stored in pointer, that is this one, the value of I is 1 and the value of address of I is 6356728. Then the if I print the value, then what will be the output? Definitely this one, right? So now comment it, so run it. Yes, then what is the address? 6356728, and it is taken by the compiler. I have not initialized it because firstly I have run the program and I have means observed the output, and the output in based on the output I have made the diagram. So don't confuse that I have just used the output file, this file, to make the diagram. Okay, I have not initialized the address. The address is taken or the reserved by the compiler or the operating system only, not by me. Okay, and you can ask me that why the address are the same and how you know. Just I have run the program before the means drawing the diagram or making the table. Okay, so now you can see. The address value which is stored in pointer is 635728. Okay, it's normal. The pointer value, the address of I is stored in pointer, and the pointer is printed, right? The pointer value is printed. Now, after incrementing address value which is stored in pointer is, I am going to comment this line too. Okay, let's check. It's obvious thing that 6356728 is stored in pointer, the value address of I, and so it is printed. Now after incrementing the address value which is stored in pointer is 6356732. Now you can observe that the pointer is not incremented by 1, though I have given the pointer plus plus, and everybody knows that pointer plus plus is means pointer is equal to pointer plus 1, pointer plus 1. Okay, but here if the general arithmetic is implemented here or the used here, then the result will be 29, right? 635678 plus 1 is equal to 29, but here what we can see, 6356732, that is incremented by 4, though I have been incremented by 1 only, right? So this is the difference between the general arithmetic and the pointer arithmetic. If it is general arithmetic, then the result will be 6356729, means incremented by only 1, but here incremented by 4. So what is the difference and between the general arithmetic and the pointer arithmetic? Go for it. Okay, so now please understand well. I plus plus means I plus 1, right? So if I is equal to 0, then I plus plus is equal to 1, simple. If I is equal to 2, then I plus 2 is equal to 4. This is the general arithmetic. Okay, but in pointer arithmetic, if j is a pointer variable and it holds the address of any variable, okay, then j plus plus or j plus 1 is address held by j plus size of data type of the variable. Then what it means what is address held by j and size of data type variable. Okay, and then again z plus 2, address held by z plus 2 into size of data type of the variable. But if it is in general arithmetic, then if I is equal to 2, then I plus 2 is equal to 4, just incremented by 1 or the number that is given, right? Here 2 by 2 is incremented, 2 is incremented by 2, then this is 4. But here, if the address hold by, if it is the pointer variable, then address hold by j plus 2 into size of data type of the variable. Now you can ask why I am teaching this pointer arithmetic, because in next, because next I am going to teach you the array, and array is a pointer only, and in array these things will be needed. Okay, so address hold by j plus 2 into size of data by the variable. So let's go for it. If j is equal to address of I, then 6356728. Okay, means address 6356728 I have taken from here. I have taken from here, and if it is j plus 1, that means j plus plus, then now see, if j plus plus or j plus 1 is address hold by j plus size of data type of the variable. So I am mentioning again that the data type integer of data type of in my machine is 4. So address hold by j, what is the address hold by j? What is address hold by j? Address hold by j is address of I, 635678, right? Here I have written, let j is equal to address of I. So what is address of I? Address of I is 635728, and j plus 1, then what will be the j plus 1? What is j plus 1? Then according to the formula, address hold by j, what is address hold by j? This one plus 1 into plus 1 into, here you can use, okay, j plus 1. So j plus 1 is equal to 6357, the address hold by the j plus 1 into size of 4. That is what will be the answer, 32, right? So 6356728 plus 4 means the size of the integer type, that is 4. Okay, then 635732 in my machine integer data type is size is 4. Okay, then go to the diagram, it will be very clear. So here the address hold by j is 635728, and if I incremented by 1, then let j, this is j, okay, and j is pointing to this one, right? But when it is incremented by 1, j plus plus, j plus plus, then logically it should increment it to the next block of memory, right? Previously, initially the j pointer is pointing to this room, okay, or the this block, but after incrementing it should point to the next block, okay. So j plus plus, so you can see that the, as the block is of size 4, then next block will be, if this the size of is 28, 6356728, then next will be 6356732, right? So that's why we cannot increment plus 1 or plus 2. We have to increment by the byte size. So plus 1 means, or incremented by 1 means incremented by the size of the data type. Understood? Means again I am saying that in general arithmetic, incremented by 1 is incremented by 1 only, but in pointer arithmetic, incremented by 1 is incremented by the 1 unit of data type, okay, the size of the data type. Simple. So in programming example, so go to pointer example. I think, hope now it is clear to you. So see, the address value which is stored in pointer is 635728, and after incrementing, the address value which is stored in the pointer is 635732. Okay, not 635729, because it is not a general arithmetic. If it is general arithmetic, then 635728 will be incremented by 1, will be 635729. But in as it is a pointer arithmetic, that it will be incremented by a the size of the data type, that is 4. Okay, so again, one more example. So let's comment it out. If I can show my diagram too. So here you can see the address value is stored in pointer is, there's a first value, okay, Z is pointing to this position first, okay, and after incremented by 2. So if it incremented by 2, then I should go to two house or two room in right side, okay. So initially Z is pointing to this side. Initially, Z is pointing to this room, okay. But after incremented by 2, I should go to this man's. If I incremented by 1, then I should go to this room. And if I incremented by 2, then I should go to this room. So after incremented by 2 address, 2, the address value is, the address value which is stored in pointer is this one, okay. So after increment, think logically that if the Z pointer is pointing to the this room. Okay, this room, and after incremented by 2, I should go to I have to shift to means two room right, okay, this side. So now the Z pointer will be pointing to this one, right? So now see the address. What is the address? 635736. Yes, the answer is same. So what we what can we conclude that if it is incremented by 2, then we should go to two room in right side. If I incremented by n, then I have to go to n room right side. Okay, so n room right side. So and here the general formula is, after pointer arithmetic, so if Z plus n, if it's n, Z is incremented by n, the Z pointer is incremented by n, then the address held by Z plus n into size of the data type of the variable. That means the value will be incremented, pointer value will be incremented by means n into the size of the data type of the variable. Okay, so thank you. I am going to teach next in array in the next video. Okay.